Hi everyone, it's Vicky here and welcome to a fun event. This week I am featuring Penny Black Stamps and I will be posting 5 videos, one for each day from Monday to Friday. So let's get started. This is the Duck and Buddy stamp set by Penny Black and it's a really adorable stamp set for making birthday cards. You get a duck and a dog and along with balloons, gifts, cupcakes, it's really adorable. I am working on a watercolor paper. You can see how thick it is. And I am going to stamp my duck with archival ink. For coloring my images today, I am going to use Tombow dual brush markers. You will see how easy they are to blend and I am also going to show you different ways to apply them. And I also have another piece of watercolor paper, which I am going to color blue for my background. Now I am using a non-porous surface as my palette and this is just printer paper that I have laminated. So I'm going to bring in my Tombow dual brush markers. You can see that I have the whole collection, but you really don't need to have all the colors. You will see later on how I use the blender pen to do lots of shading just by one marker. But first of all, I am going to do a simple technique here to apply the blue color on my background, on my sky. So I am just going to apply from the brush tip a little bit on my non-porous palette. And with the brush, I am just going to wet the watercolor paper first. And then I am going to pick up the color from my palette with my brush and apply it directly on my piece of paper. The way I am applying the color is diluting the color with the water so I get a nice wash of color without the blue being super vibrant. I'm just going to cover up the background and at the same time I mainly focused on concentrating the color at the top so I get that ombre look. Another way to apply them for getting a vibrant color is to directly color on your paper. However, I am going to show you how you can use one yellow and one orange to color the whole duck. But I am going to do the trick with the blending tool. So just by applying a little bit of my brush on one side of the duck where I think that it should be darker. And then with my blending tool, I'm going to bring the color towards the other side. And you will see that it's super easy to use. You get so many different color variations from just one marker. And I really don't need to use a second yellow marker to do the shading. I'm going to repeat the exact same process, applying just a little bit of my marker again in the same spot where the darker is, just to make it a little bit more vibrant. And my duck is pretty much finished. Now, the main body. Now, I am going to do the exact same technique for the orange parts. You can see how I can bleed the color with my blending tool. And you can really do the exact same technique by using your brush and dipping it into the water instead of using the blending tool. In that case, you will get a less vibrant color, but you will get a more watercolored look. You can clean the tip of your blending tool, as you can see, really easy. And again, the same technique for the balloon. So you see, by using only 3 colors, I got all those different shadings and lighting areas on my duck. And just because I had so much fun coloring this duck, I decided to color the little dog too. And in the dog, you can see how instead of using the blending marker, I am using just a brush and dipping it into water. I'm going to put some music and meet you back here once all the coloring is done. Thank you. Now that I have finished coloring my images, I am going to use my scissors and cut them out. To make my life easier, I am going to cut out a thin border all around them. So my image is now ready. I'm going to punch out a few clouds using my cloud punch. You can use a die or you can cut them out by hand. And I'm going to stick everything down by using foam squares. This is going to add a little bit of dimension on my card. I will also use three little clouds for my little scene there, and I am going to stick as if they are behind the little duck. And I also like to stick elements that are going outside of my main frame, just for more interest. Once I decide where everything is going to go, I'm just going to commit and stick them down. I am cutting the excess paper with my scissors, and now all that's left to do is to add the sentiment. Now for the sentiment, I'm going to use the Happy Birthday from the same stamp set, but just because I want it to be a long one, I have cut it out in half so that I can place it, so that I can place one word next to the other. I'm going to use an acrylic block that has a grid on top, which is going to help me make sure that those are nicely lined up, the words. And now I'm going to stamp with Versamark ink on black cardstock. I'm going to apply bright white embossing powder, heat set it with my heat gun, cut out the strip, and I really like how vibrant that white looks against the black border. And since all the colors at my card are quite pale, I really like the vibrancy of the sentiment. It really stands out. I'm going to stick this, I have made a fishtail on one side and I'm going to stick it down. And again, I am going to use foam squares at the back. And while I'm doing that, just to remind you that you can find the full list of all the supplies that I'm using today just below the video in the description area as well as on my blog. I have added a few dots on my balloon, white dots with my gel pen. And I can really go on and on with my finishing touches on my cards. So now I have grabbed my Wink of Stella clear glitter pen, adding a little bit of glitter on the balloon, on some parts of the cute little duck, as well as on the clouds. For the duck also, I am going to make the eye a little bit more vibrant by using my black enamel. Before you go ahead and add a black enamel on your duck and ruin whatever you have done already, it's nice to test it out on a scrap piece of paper. Finally, I'm going to use glossy accents. And my panel is pretty much finished. For my second card, the one with the little dog, I did the exact same thing. You can see it's exactly the same design. So I'm using some tape runner at the back of my panels and I'm sticking them on my card bases. For my card bases today, I'm using white cardstock. That's a standard card, a top folding card that's 4.25 by 5.5. And that was the project for today. I hope you had fun and got inspired. And if you did, don't forget to leave me a comment as well as give me a thumbs up on my YouTube channel. If you really like my videos, don't forget to share them with your friends. Here are some close-up photos of the cards. And if you need more inspiration, here are two more videos where I have used penny black stamps for those cards. Thank you all for watching!